We're continuing now with our conversation on legislation at the Minnesota Capitol regarding future elections and a DFL legislation that has been introduced and lawmakers are taking a look at. We heard from Representative Greenman, DFL, who is sponsoring part of this bill. Now we're going to turn our attention to Republican Representative Steve Draskowski, who is from Mazeppa but happens to be in Winona at the moment, weighing in on the DFL election legislation. And Steve, you don't disagree, I'm thinking, that changes need to be made to our state election system, correct?
Oh, absolutely, Betsy. Yeah, the question is which direction we go. There's always been a tug and pull, and certainly there is this time presenting itself again. Democrats always want to make the rules easier, make access super duper easy, remove any personal responsibility from the equation around elections. Republicans want integrity in our elections, want to make sure the person voting is who they say they are, and make sure that it's hard to cheat. Democrats want to go the other direction. And you saw that in the bill that Representative Greenman, the new freshman legislator, has introduced. They want to bring government to actually send ballots out to people. We heard about that happening in other states. She wants to bring that to Minnesota. We should be instead, Betsy, instead of making it easier for people to cheat, which is everything that her bill does, instead of doing that, we should have provisional balloting in Minnesota. I introduced that bill just 2 days ago. And photo ID in Minnesota. Many states have photo ID requirements to make sure their elections have integrity. The person is who they say they are, and it's difficult to cheat.
And this is one of the pieces of this that I asked her about, and I want to ask you about as well. So the contentious issue with requiring a photo ID becomes an issue because there are plenty of people who are eligible to vote who have an established residence who may not have that photo ID. Therefore, that piece of it then becomes the problem. So is there another way around this? And I guess I'm trying to figure out, you call it cheating. They say it just makes it easier for those who are eligible to vote to vote.
Yeah, well, Betsy, I saw cheating firsthand in Minneapolis in the primary election in June when Liban Mohammed came out with 300 ballots in his car from one day. I was there when the young lady who captured the video from his Snapchat gave it to me, and I am 100% certain about the authenticity of that video. Democrats will continue to deny that, but it's true. We can ask the people. We can ask the 300 elderly Somali people who this one individual stole the votes from and ask them what they think about that. The reality is there are ideas in other states. Other states have photo ID, and they have situations where if somebody doesn't have an ID, the government will give them an ID. That's part of the bill. So there really aren't any reasons or any rational reasons the Democrats have here. And as I was going to mention before, 47 states have provisional balloting. Minnesota does not. That would add security to it. I introduced that bill as well 2 days ago.
Talk to me about this DFL legislation would allow convicted felons to have their voting rights restored. What do you feel about that?
Yeah, I think that that is going to create even more of a mess in that particular area. I haven't examined exactly what their proposal is. But we have a reason, and it's in our Constitution, that says that if you are convicted of a felony, you cannot vote. So they want to manipulate the law to get around that constitutional requirement, and we can't do that. The Constitution, Betsy, was violated this last year in Minnesota and a number of other states when a national Democrat organization called Democracy Docket came to Minnesota. And this was a Democrat Party organization, Democracy Docket, came to Minnesota, sued the state, and said, we want to get rid of the signature requirements, the witness signature requirements on absentee ballots. In the court defending our state was Secretary of State Steve Simon, also a liberal Democrat, and the judge was a past Dayton appointee who was a past state political director for Senator Amy Klobuchar. That's what they have. They changed the rules. It's against our Constitution for those two branches, the executive branch and the judicial branch, to change the rules, which is the laws that the legislature sets. It's also against Article 1, Section 4 of the U.S. Constitution and Article 2, Section 1 of the U.S. Constitution that says specifically state legislatures have to set their election laws. They violated that right before our eyes. Now they want to write it into law with Representative Greenman's bill.
I appreciate your time on this, Steve. Representative Steve Drazkowski, there is much more to this. We will be hearing about it in the weeks ahead, still in the session. Steve, thank you.
Thank you, Betsy.